Hi, this is Federico at Cuttle, and in this video, we're going to explore one of the basic techniques for making one-piece pop-up cards. First, I'll show you how to do it by hand to give you an idea of the structure, and then we'll make a digital version that we can export and then score and cut on the vinyl cutter. When you create a pop-up, you usually create new little creases where other smaller pop-ups can be made, and this process can be repeated multiple times down the line. Paul Jackson calls those multiple versions generations of the same pop-up. So in the third part of the video, I'm going to show you how to use components in Cuttle to easily create those iterations and hopefully find some cool designs. So let's get started. We'll start by folding the card in half, then marking the center on the spine, and then the halfway point across. Then we'll cut a slit, and then fold it. Then when we unfold the whole card, we can push that section out. Now we'll do the second generation. We'll measure the center, then halfway point across, cut the slit, fold two pieces. And when we open the card, we'll push those out. Then press it down to reinforce the creases, and that's our second generation. For the third generation, we can repeat the same steps four more times. Our design is going to be flat, so I'm gonna lay down and highlight all the creases so what we do on the screen becomes more clear. So let's see what it looks like in Cuttle. My first step is going to be creating that unfolded card where the design is going to go. So to do that, I'm going to grab a rectangle from the left-hand side. I'm going to place it on the center. And I'm going to make it 7 inches by 5 inches. I found out that that size allows me to cut two cards out of a letter-sized piece of cardstock. And I want to give this component a name, so I'm going to double click on the left hand side, and I'm going to call this one the card blank. Now I want to start sketching out those horizontal cuts and those vertical folds that are going to make up my design. So I'm going to create a new component. Then I'm going to drag that card blank component onto the canvas. I'm going to zoom out so we can see. For this design, I'm going to be using the pen tool a lot. And if you're new to it, this is going to be a quick introduction, but I'm also going to link to a video that shows you more in detail what you can do with it. So if you want to make a simple line, you can click where you want the line to start, and then you can click where you want the line to end. And then to finish, you can click the select tool. And here we have created our first slit, but I want that to be on the center. So I'm going to drag it from the midpoint onto the center. Now I want to draw those vertical lines that are going to be the folds that I'm going to score with the machine, but then I'm going to be folding by hand. So I'm going to use the same method using the pen tool. So here's where I want the line to start, and then I'm going to hold shift so the line is constrained to be perfectly vertical. And here's where I want the line to end. And something you can do when you're drawing multiple lines is that you can press escape in between them. So you still have the pen tool active. Similarly, I'm going to hold shift. And when I want to finish, I can press V, which is the keyboard shortcut for the selection tool. So I want to differentiate these two lines because they're scores, they're not cuts. And I'm going to give them a different color. So I'm going to select them, and here in the stroke color, I'm going to choose something like a deep red. So this one is also going to be red. And then there's going to be a line down the middle, so I'm going to draw it really quick. this would be my centerfold. At this point, I could keep on drawing lines in the same fashion, but I want to use Cuttle's unique features because I know I'm going to be reusing this slit. I'm going to turn it into a component. So I'm going to right-click on it and then select Extract as Component. So as you can see, now it's on the left-hand side. And I'm going to rename it. I'm going to call it the slit for the cut. And I'm going to move it up just to keep things organized. There are a couple of ways in which I can reuse this component. So one way is to simply drag it from the left, like any other geometry, and place it where I want it. In this case, the midpoint of that line. And then the other way is to duplicate an existing one. So I can right-click on it and hit Duplicate. So that creates a copy of it and place it where I want it. And I know these two need to be half the size of the previous one. So I'm going to select it and change the scale. In this case, 50%. And again. And for the next set of folds, I'm gonna keep it simple. So I'm gonna draw them again with the pen tool. So I'm gonna press escape in between lines. So the pen tool stays active. And I'm holding shift to keep it constrained. And when I'm done, I'm gonna hit V to change the selection tool. And I need these to be also red, so I'm gonna select them and change the stroke color to red. And now for the final generation, I'm gonna duplicate one of those instances of the slit. I'm gonna use Command D, although you could use Control D on Windows. I'm gonna place it where I want it. And I know that I want that one to be half of the previous one, half the size of the previous one. So that's going to be 25%. And I will duplicate these again and place it where I want it. And finally, I'm going to draw all those folds, pressing escape in between the lines and holding shift to keep them perfectly vertical. And when I'm done, I'm going to press V, which changes onto the selection tool. Oop, that last one needs to be on the line. So to finish it, I'm going to select them all while holding shift. That allows me to make a selection of a bunch of different pads, and I'm going to change the color to red. And I think at this point, we are ready to export it. In this case, I'm going to go to File and export an SVG for Cricut, which is going to do a couple of nice things for us, like pre-attaching all those red lines so I can select the operation all at once. So let me show you what that looks like. I'm going to save that file and let's see what it looks like on Design Space. So here in Design Space, I'm going to upload that SVG file. Then I'm going to select it and add it to the canvas. And so as you can see, we have two groups of operations. On one side, we have all these lines that are going to be the score, and then we have these lines that are going to be the cuts, including the outside cut, and they are nicely grouped. So I need to change the vertical lines into a score and then select everything, attach it so it's on a single mat, and then we can make it. with the scoring wheel, we created the lines where the folds would go, but we still need to finish them by hand. So the interesting thing about making something even as simple as a line into a component is that now I can make changes that are going to spread throughout all the instances of that component. So there are a couple of ways in which we can edit a single component. So one way is I can go to the component itself, and to edit this line, I'm going to double click. So I go into path editing mode, and then I'm going to add an additional anchor just by double clicking and then moving it. So that edits that particular component. And if I see now, you can see that all the changes have spread throughout all the other ones. But another easy way to edit them is I can still double click here. And if I edit this path, you can see how the changes spread throughout all the other ones. So this kind of house looking thing is the thing I want to do next. So I'm going to export it again and let's see what it looks like. Now for the next version, I'm going to edit that path again, double click a couple of times, then delete that anchor point. And what I want to do is turn this path into a guide. That means it won't get exported as geometry, but I can still use it because I know any of my cuts need to go between these two points. So I'm going to see the path on the right hand side, and there is an option that says guides visible, so it turns the shapes into guides. So it has a light red color now. So I'm gonna go again into component editing mode, and instead of a line, I'm gonna grab one of these arcs. So I'm gonna place the arc on the center, and then I'm gonna put the handle where I want it to start and the other handle where I want it to end. So as you can see, that creates those arcs here. And another thing we can do with components is that we can change the geometry or we can add new geometry. So in this case, I want to add a circle in the center. And as you can see, that circle also gets added and scaled to the other instances of the component. So I think this is the next version I want to export. So let's see what that looks like. So for the last variation, let's edit that component again. So I'm going to delete the circle and I'm going to delete the arc, and I'm going to draw a sort of zigzag line. And in order to make sure the lines are parallel, I want to show you another trick, which is whenever I select an anchor point, I can always type and determine exactly where the position is. So in this case, I want it to be 0.75 inches above the x-axis. And this other anchor, I can select it and make it 0.75 inches below the x-axis. So that makes sure those are parallel. So let's export this example. I can show you what it looks like. And there will be a link to this project in the description where you can download any of the examples. And I hope this pop-up exploration was interesting to you. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. And thank you so much for watching.